here. They are, let's see, they turn 3 weeks old on Monday, so they're almost 3 weeks old. But Batman's eyes are both completely open, and even more awesome, they are both very blue eyes, like bright blue eyes. Sorry about that. So he has gorgeous, gorgeous eyes, and we noticed that this morning. So his eyes are now completely open. He can see entirely, and so the two of them are learning to play together. They're figuring out that they can cause a reaction from the other one, and so they're doing really silly things to each other to watch how the other reacts. So it's been a lot of fun. And I brought them over here to take the thumbnail picture and figured I would just start the live here because they're so cute. I don't want to move them.
These are the ones that you got. Here, Bradley. I was saying, if you want to try these ones on, Bradley, these are the ones you got last year.
I should take a screenshot. They're so cute. When I took the picture, just the picture that YouTube took right here was better than the thumbnail one I had.
Oh, really?
Yeah. How cute are they? I don't want to move them away from the tree because they're so cute. But so today we're gonna bring more of our dogs around to start introducing them. Nothing crazy. We'll just bring in the ones that have. See if you can see his blue eyes. It has to be pretty bright. Like you need light. So. I'll go ahead and start taking them to their mama. Say hi, boo. Say big yawn. Oh, big yawn. Oh, my. Oh, my. There's the mama. There's the mama. Were you looking for your puppies underneath the bed? Let's go get Batman. I'm gonna see if I can show you Batman's eyes. Don't know if I can get the right angle. I might need to wait till it's a little brighter. He's going for a ride. Oh, I wonder if we can see your eyes now. I don't think so. I can't tell. They're so pretty. No, we can't. Yeah, Christmas.
Right, or May. No, don't. We're taking the bolo.
Turn the. We have to run somewhere, but when we come back, I'm going to bring in the dogs for socialization purposes, the dogs that have already met the puppies. And so Spike has met them before, so we'll bring Dad in and Daisy and Robin. They haven't met Missy, so we won't bring Missy in. or macchiato.
Carefully sniffing the tree. good on you. Man.
It just feels small. I see what Mace is like. I forgot like how high their jackets
are. Yeah,
called.
They ride high. Yeah, they ride high. Because it's meant to give you, you know, range of motion. That fits you perfectly.
Really?
Yeah, that's the way they're supposed to be worn. It's not going to be as warm fuzzy side out.
For the shoulders don't look really good.
Right.
The stitching on the shoulders is up here now.
Weird. It's funny that the fuzz makes that big of a difference.
Yeah, it fits with the fuzzy side out, so I'll just wear it in that.
It's really cute. It is very cute. May doesn't like it, though.
Well, I mean, you know, there's like a thing right now how kids don't wear coats and that is kind of stupid. Socks. I thought those like last three
you
were grabbing. But they offered them to you.
You're
like, you know what?
I will
take them.
Oh, I was like, if you are having a hard time getting rid of the extra larges, I'll take them. And she was like, oh, yes, here, thank you. That's kind of nice.
Because these are like,
I know, bombers are expensive.
And you can tell that these are, or the promotional ones.
Right.
But they're,
They're for 13 plus, so they're a little bit big. But
that will be fine because you're always small. Maybe you won't bust them out.
Oh, I see. Look at you, cutie pie. Holy smokes, those fit you perfect.
Oh, wow, Bella, I didn't realize you.
Did you
see small, but not for me. Look how cool that is. Look, do you see the little butterfly or whatever that is? An insect?
It's a bee.
It's a bee. Those are so cool, Bella.
Oh, that's Bradley.
Can I play with that?
Bradley.
Mom,
hey, where are your socks, dude?
Oh,
they, you know, they say, like, for every order of Bombas, they donate or whatever.
No, every pair they sell.
God.
Yeah, so they have, you know, mark it up.
Yeah, I couldn't miss them.
And I always kind of figure that they were not donating the same quality
size. Right, yeah, I thought, but they look pretty
nice. But these are pretty decent.
Daddy! Daddy!
Yeah, that's why when...
Daddy! Daddy, hi, boy!
Yeah,
you
want to
play bowling?
What, baby?
You want to play bowling?
Do I want to play bowling?
Yeah, it's only for two
players. Oh, and I want to see why they had it set up at a different table, because that was
because
just...
May got a bunch of socks from...
She got a bunch of socks from the kids' side. Heather got ones that she'll probably wear, because they have, like, the number one princess. It's, like, that sort of stuff.
Oh, because I saw that it was from this shoe place. Bella, that is not a slide.
Drive thing that they do.
Yeah. Oh man, these are nice.
Daddy, we have twinners. We have twinners.
No, we got twinners.
Twins.
Besties, bestie sockies.
And we both have jeans.
Yeah, we have both have the jeans.
But Dad, we don't have the same shirts, right?
Oh man, these are nice.
Where should I put the coats in the wash? Yeah.
Probably as activewear.
Dad, you play bowling.
Oh, baby, hold on, just let me see. Let me help Mom.
Mom.
What's up, sweetheart? Huh? Man, why is the screen so dark?
Oh, Bella, your shoes are awesome.
Hi there, Diana. Hi, Diana. How are you? I wanted to... I wish I had more time. When I set up the stream this morning, we were kind of like running out the door to go to a church thing. And so it kind of was unfortunate because I didn't have much time. But after I took the thumbnail picture, which I ended up not using, but I took pictures of the puppies under the tree again. And they were being so sweet that I just decided to go live right there while they were being sweet. And unfortunately, we had to get going, so I couldn't keep the live out there with them. But I think tomorrow I'm going to set it up like that again so that we can let the puppies play with the Christmas lights, because with their eyes and everything, they love playing with Christmas lights. Go potty, fat man. Good boy. Good go potty. Good go potty. Good boy. Good go potty, fat man. What a good boy. What a good boy. That's a good go potty. That's a good go potty. What a good boy. Let's see if you can see his blue eyes. Oh, poor guy. Stop. Open your eyes for us. Maybe when we have more light in here. But they're super. They're so sweet. They look like little baby blue eyes. You go potty, blue. Let me actually. You go potty. Go potty, Blue. Go potty, Blue. Go potty, good boy, Blue. Good boy. Good go potty. Good boy. That a boy. Good go potty. Good boy, Blue. Good go potty. Good boy. Good go potty. Good go potty. So basically, to do this, if you haven't been on when I explained before, I apologize if you're hearing me repeat myself for the 100th time, but so their moms, when they are first born, in order to potty, they're not able to potty on their own, and so mom just starts licking them basically from here to their butts. And then that massaging that she does stimulates them to go potty and poop. And so what we do, you see him trying to crawl. What we do is we try to capitalize on that ability to kind of push a button and make them go potty. We try to capitalize on that because there's really no other time that we can make them go potty. And so initially we offer the puppy to mom to potty, and we do it over the pine so that they, in their eyes open, they can see it, but they can smell it, feel it. And then the more mom potties them with the pine, the more they start associating that when they potty, they have the pine. And like now that we're about a week into potty training, we don't really need mom all the time. They'll go potty just with us. If you scroll back, you can see, but we just do like a little tickle like that, and it makes them go potty. And so then when they're going potty, that's when we reward them and praise them, and so they can start making the connection. But there's something very invaluable with the fact that with the ability to make them, to know that we can make them potty basically on command, because that puts us much more ahead of where we would be otherwise with potty training. Like if they were 4 months old and we were just trying to potty train them and we didn't have any way to just make them go potty so we could say, hey, this is potty, this is where it goes. As I'm sure you know, it's not that easy. But when they're this age, when we have this ability to just like literally press a button on their belly and then they go potty, it's really easy and real quick for them to start associating, like, oh yeah, hey, potty in the pine. And so we do basically try to capitalize as much as we can on that for as long as it lasts. And you'll see us pottying them pretty much every day until they're about, probably about 4-ish weeks old when they are consistently going to the potty tray to go potty. We'd probably actually stop pottying them a little sooner than that. We just will plop them into the potty tray and tell them to go potty, and they, by 4 weeks old, they understand the command to go potty. And so if we tell them to just go potty, they'll start sniffing around looking for a place.
last warning. You need to lose your attitude, or else you're not switching rooms.
Daddy, do you want a bedroom?
Come on, baby girl.
I'll just find it for you. Can you play dice?
Do you have all six dice in there?
We had seven. I found the other ones. They were like under the book.
Under the book?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
These were under the book. And then I got them.
That is a dice and it goes with the game.
Yep. Do you want to play? You don't play now, Dad?
Hold on, baby. We're going to need to go and help clean up.
I don't.
The living room is a big old mess.
I don't want to clean up.
I know you don't want to, sweetheart, but we need to help.
Pom-Pom. They're looking for you, sweetie. They're looking for you. Look at how active they are. I'm not sure if they're just looking for mom or what, but they're so active. They're so big. Look how big they are. I don't think I've seen them this active before. This is where they start learning how to wrestle. They start figuring out that they can get a reaction out of the other. They kind of like learn accidentally.
Thank you.
forgot about it.
Oh, man.
He never noticed.
There's Mama back. Mama's back. How did they fall asleep?
Yeah, that was a good one. Because I, honest to God, thought that was real.
He's a good mama.
Bradley.
What?
Come here. Bradley,
see if we can see his pretty blue eyes. He's got the prettiest blue eyes. But we gotta get the light on him just right so we can see. Are you pottying him, Pom Pom? Now she's gonna make him potty. Talk about a demo. Come on, fat man, can we see your blue eyes? They're so pretty. Oh, big yawn. Oh, look at those pretty eyes. I wish the camera could capture them. Oh, Pom Pom, why did you lick my nose? Such a good boy. He's so big, he's gonna roll right out of my arms. Can you see it? What a good boy you are. What a good boy you are. Oh, no teeth. Good boy. Pom Pom. Checking on your baby. He's such a good boy. He's gonna make such a good cavalier. Oh, big yawn. Oh, you want your mama. Oh, you want your mama. He wants his mama. He wants his mama. Him wants, him wants. And there she goes pottying him again. Which is, I've talked before about how frequently they go potty. For a little bit of perspective, she just pottied him just now in like a full bladder, and I pottied him about 20 minutes ago. So that's how quickly they produce urine. Oh, the good boy. Oh, I can see his blue. Oh. You're so wiggly. Here. You want to eat? I pointed out a couple times before, so if you weren't on when I did, pay attention to their tails when they nurse, especially when they're little. When they're little and they've got their front paws on mom to nurse. And then they have their back paws balancing them. And so they use their tails. They hold them out straight. You can see blue's back here. They hold it to balance. They hold them out straight. And then it turns at like a 90 degree angle. He's laying on his side, so it's kind of hard to see. But it's really interesting to watch because when they're little and they haven't put on all this weight, that kind of keeps them upright. They just kind of will tilt side to side as they nurse and as they're massaging mom. And so they use, as they tilt side to side, you can see their tail flex to keep them balanced. There, that's a pretty good visual. It goes straight out and down. Oh, Pom Pom. Your babies are hungry. They will stay latched at all costs. They're such silly puppies. I can't wait to move them into the bigger pen so that we can like really get in and play with them. I was so disappointed that I didn't have more time when I started the live this morning. So I think tomorrow when I start the live, I'm going to start it out in the living room and have Pom-Pom and the puppies out, and we're going to start the live, and we're just going to play in the living room instead of just starting it in here. I'll pull them out when they've been pottied, when they've been fed, and they've napped so that they're awake, and maybe we can see them try to play with each other like they did a little bit ago. That was really sweet. I'm going to have to timestamp that when the video posts. But when you see them next to each other, kind of like, it's almost like they do what babies do, the parallel play, where they'll play together but not with each other. And so that's kind of what they do. They'll just be like right next to each other, kind of rolling around, batting at things, and then they'll accidentally knock into the other one, and then they'll respond, and so they start kind of figuring it out. Oh, Mama just wants to get cozy. It's okay, Pom-Pom, you can get cozy. You're a good girl, Papa. You're a good girl. What did you guys do? Why do you have her nipples all twisted? It's not hurt, Mom. Okay. Thank you, guys. There we go.
I found one. Probably didn't have this in my purse.
I
dusk into Bella's room. She picked a really
Bella, no, baby, yes.
She's really upset because she doesn't have any makeup. And
Bella doesn't have any makeup?
She's still dead. She wants to sit at the desk and do makeup for the vanity. So I was trying to explain to her that her birthday is coming up.
Yeah, your birthday is coming up, baby. Maybe you can ask for some makeup for your birthday. Baby, you only
What's the matter? Only how many sleeps?
Three sleeps until your birthday. That's not long at all to wait to see if maybe you get
makeup
to use for your birthday. Can you wait that long?
Can you wait three sleeps? And you want to see puppies? Will that help you feel better?
And then, Bella, on your birthday, when is your birthday? And if Bella gets makeup on her birthday, it will be Bella's own special makeup. It won't be
May's makeup.
Yeah, it won't be May's leftover makeup. It won't be May's used makeup. It'll be Bella's brand new makeup.
That you get to keep.
Yeah, that you get to keep in your makeup desk.
She can see that she's opening the doors, trying to see if there's something she could use. Oh, I got an idea. You can take your brush. Let's get all the things that go with the vanity like that. Let's get all the things. Brushes, combs, hair ties.
And also a makeup brush.
It's a lip. It's like a lip. It's a lip thing. I found this.
What's a lip thing?
Like lipstick.
Oh.
This is all stuff
on you.
And also, I need a bug spray and a brush and a sprayer.
Okay.
Bye bye, Dad.
Yay!
cool stuff.
Well, I can get you like some lotion and stuff.
Here. Is this good?
No,
Just two more.
No, Bella. Mommy's giving you a lot, sweetie pie.
Bella, come on.
Eyeshadows.
Come on. You have plenty of eyeshadow.
Where?
Upstairs already?